I was looking on eBay for a pair of realistic Minima 7 speakers when I came across these speakers instead. So I figured, why not give them a try, because they're really cheap. $17.51 with free shipping. They're called Mini 3-inch Bookshelf Stereo Speakers. They don't have any brand name. They're totally generic. And they don't have any specifications listed. So it was a total gamble, but we'll see how they turned out. They were smaller than I expected. They're only about 5.5 inches tall and about 4 inches wide. And they do have 3-inch drivers for removable cloth grill. It's a foam surround, but seems to be pretty nice quality. There is no information on them at all. They have RCA plugs on them. So I figured, why not test a pair of cheap speakers with a cheap stereo system? In this case, the Sound Design. I already did a review of this stereo a while back. And it has RCA speaker jacks, so it makes it a perfect match. So here we go. That is with the expanded bass turned on, and you can see how I have the graphic equalizer set. The bass is about halfway and treble is about a third of the way up.
Hi, it's Q1043. Who's this?
This is Dominic.
That was loud.
Dominic, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Gip Hawk.
That's a head.
She took the note that he gave her, opened it slowly, and started to read.
And very soon I saw you kissing someone new beneath the moon. I thought you loved me. You said you loved me. We planned together to dream forever.
So I think they sound pretty darn good for their size. Obviously, you can't expect a lot of bass from these little speakers, but considering how small they are, they don't do too bad. They'll be just fine for background music. Just need an amplifier that can give them a decent amount of bass boost, and then they do pretty well. Otherwise, if you have everything set flat, then of course they're going to sound very tinny. See, that's if everything's set flat, but if I turn up the bass, then it makes a major improvement in the sound.
One great classic oldie,
I'd like to hear more of it.
After another, WMTR AM 1250.
My mind.
course, if you turn it up too much, then you get distortion. But honestly, I don't know if it's the amplifier causing the distortion or the speakers, because this is such a cheap amplifier.
Yeah, don't mind, but do you mean I am the one who could dance on the floor and around?
Here's one of the speakers with the driver taken out. You can see there's some insulation material in there. And you can see the driver has a nice big magnet on it. There are absolutely no markings on it anywhere that I can see. So, unfortunately, no wattage rating or anything. Not even the impedance. Also, these speakers are not magnetically shielded. So, definitely keep them away from CRT monitors, floppy disks, cassette tapes, or anything like that. But it seems to be a pretty nice quality driver in there. That big magnet, that explains why they sound so good despite being only 3 inches. Pulled out my old 1970s Panasonic stereo, and it has made a major improvement in the sound quality of these little speakers. I do have the bass turned all the way up, and with that setting, I'm really surprised how good these speakers sound. By the way, I cleaned this volume potentiometer using WD-40 back in December 2008. And there are people who say using WD-40 to clean a pot will ruin it. But that was over 6 years ago. And as you heard, it got a little scratchy again because I haven't used this stereo in quite a long time. But after a little bit of use, it's cleared up and it's perfectly fine now. So I definitely give my full recommendation for these cheapo, no-name eBay speakers. You just need to use them with a good quality amplifier and then they'll sound great.